I'm Kalyon Fuseki, based at the UCL Institute for Sustainable Heritage, and I will present the European Network on Heritage Values, which is one of the projects funded by the JPI scheme. And this is a project coordinated by UCL, by the Center for Applied Archaeology and the Institute for Sustainable Heritage. We are on the top row, but we have partners from the University of Leiden and the Eindhoven University, so bringing together archaeology and architecture. Also, our other partner is the Norwegian Institute for Cultural Heritage Research in Norway, and they bring expertise in conservation, ethnography, and ethnology. And our last partner is the University of Barcelona in Spain, and they bring expertise in archaeology and history. So we are quite an interdisciplinary team, and that was, of course, the purpose of that, because we wanted to understand how heritage values are being understood in across different disciplines, but more importantly, across different European countries. So what we were sensing is that there is a rapidly growing literature on this idea of heritage values, but we wanted to see how this translates into practice, and more importantly, among different countries, and how they are using, if at all, this concept, and also how they measure them, how they assess heritage values in order to make decisions and prioritize which heritage elements, whether this is an archaeological site or whether this is a historic building or whether this is a museum collection, are being selected for preservation. And the values is quite central in that decision. And another objective was to explore projects that involve actively the wider public. And of course, the public as a term can be quite problematic. So here, it means anyone who is not an expert, like, for example, local communities, and how they're involved in the assessment of values. What we wanted to do through this, what we wanted and still want to do through this network, is to bring together not only academics, but more importantly, practitioners who work in different heritage organizations, like museums, local authorities, but also policymakers, people who work for governmental organizations, and they are the ones who develop the policy documents. And the reason why we want to do that is because we can sense that values are understood quite differently among the different sectors, and we wanted to see what the impact of that discrepancy is in the actual heritage practice. So how we do this network? We are organizing three different events, two of which have already been organized. One, the first one was in Eindhoven, and the theme of that workshop was to deconstruct the concept of heritage values in different disciplines. So we had people from conservation, architecture, museum studies, ethnology, ethnography, engineering. And it was quite interesting to see how the different disciplines approach this concept. The second workshop was in Oslo, just about a month ago. And the goal of that workshop was to exchange experiences with the different practitioners on what methodologies they use for assessing values. How these methodologies have been developed throughout the years. So we had some very interesting examples from the Netherlands, from one methodology that was recently developed by the Cultural Heritage Agency, which was quite interesting because they pointed out the significance of being transparent and critically reflective. So they try to develop a methodology which is not just simply ticking like a box exercise where you go through different values typologies, but they are prompting questions that make you think and reflect. And of course, this is pretty new, and it has been tested to see how effective it is. But there were some fundamental principles that we discussed with the practitioners and the policymakers and other academics on how that should drive the development of different methodologies, and that methodologies should be flexible enough to adopt, to adjust them on the particular case studies. And then we have the Barcelona workshop, which is the next one that will take place in February. And the theme there is about the public and how we engage and involve the public in value assessment. Now the workshops are not, they do not follow the traditional conference style, and that was a decision that we made very specifically about, because we wanted to find more interactive and as innovative as possible ways to engage and have a dialogue and learn through discussions and learn through interaction, which is something that the practitioners really valued as an opportunity, because it creates automatically a more relaxed atmosphere where people can be more open and share their own experiences in a rather nice way. We did have all sorts of activities, like we also had visits to different places where we could test different tools and then coming back and trying to see and reflect how each tool worked and which ones we should use and why we think some of the tools are useful. So that was actually quite interesting to see, again, the different approaches and also the differences between different countries, and especially the idea of transparency, which again can be sometimes problematic in some European countries in terms of how much information do you reveal in order to justify your decisions. So far we have had participants from different countries, including Palestine, UK, France, Italy, Serbia, Netherlands, Sweden, Spain, Belgium, Cyprus, Poland, Croatia, Norway, Hungary, Germany, Greece, and Latvia. So we want really to see, to if possible, to have participants from the whole Europe. Ideally, that's the plan. And some of the outcomes are firstly, we want to advance our theoretical understanding of how heritage values are conceptualized across different disciplines, but also across different sectors and geographical regions. The second outcome is to develop a general platform or guidelines for shaping methodological frameworks that are suitable for assessing and measuring heritage values. And the final one is to advance our knowledge through shared experience of public involvement in assessing heritage. We have started developing a virtual library, which will be hosted by the website of the project, that will show the website, of existing methodologies for assessing heritage values. Also, we have established the state of the art, and there are two already reports which will be uploaded on the website on public participatory projects in value assessment, but also how values are conceived among different disciplines. And these reports are not just literature reviews, that was a first step, but they have been informed and incorporated the discussions that have taken place during the workshops, which actually have provided a new insight in relation to what has been written so far in the literature. And the final one is that we want, and we have already started identifying areas for further research, since the ultimate goal is to develop a research partnership across Europe and a research proposal. And we want to, what we have been doing so far is to really cultivate a partnership between these different sectors, like the academic sector, but also the heritage practitioners sector as well. We have more or less six working packages. The first one is the project management, which is continuing, of course. There is a second one, and I will show you in a minute, the needs analysis, where we are trying to understand what the heritage sector needs in terms of heritage values and what research needs to be done in order to address those needs. The third one is, as I said, the Eindhoven workshop, which is complete. The fourth one is the workshop in Oslo, which is complete. And the fifth working package relates to the Barcelona workshop. And finally, of course, the dissemination, which I will present. So as I said, we were sensing that there are some discrepancies, or at least that was the sense from the literature, between academics, practitioners, and policymakers. And in terms of how they understand and use the heritage values term, how they measure them, how they assess them. For example, what we were finding, especially within the policy making documents, is that values are being understood as something you can measure, more like a benefit that you can measure in economic terms. While when within the heritage conservation field, values there was a tendency for values to be classified and use different typologies in order to make decisions and priorities. But when looking in more theoretical studies on heritage values, the idea is that values is something intangible, something you cannot measure. So we can see already some tensions and conflicts between the different sectors. However, during the workshops, we have seen that actually the conflict is not that dramatic as it is represented in the actual literature. But what is more important is indeed this instigation of dialogue and critical reflection. And that's something we have put in our reports. We also have a survey which is ongoing. The deadline is the 30th of November, and I may circulate the questionnaire to you if you are interested in responding. And this survey, which I will present in a minute, it has been translated into Greek. I'm originally from Greece, so it was easy to do, in Catalan, Spanish, and Italian. But of course, most of the responses are from English speaking, not necessarily people who live in the UK or the States, but English speaking. So we had to utilize our language skills to translate the survey. But the reason why we decided to translate it and get responses is because it's so interesting to see in the native language of someone exactly to capture the meaning and how they use the values. I think this has been lost if you try to translate like the Greek term of values into English. You can only really sense of what they mean if you ask them to respond in Greek. But of course, we couldn't cover more than those languages because these are the languages we speak within our partners. So our ultimate goal in the future would be to really expand that and have more partners from many more different countries and translate this survey in many different languages. It is actually a rather short survey, of course, because we are quite aware of the fact that practitioners specifically don't have a lot of time, but as a starting point to capture the needs, it has worked quite effectively. It starts with an open box, so which is simply what heritage values mean to you. And I think the most important data are coming from these little open boxes. And the findings, of course, of the survey will again be presented and uploaded on the website. Then there is a question on how they feel in terms of assessing and measuring heritage values, whether they think this is something you can do through typologies, through qualitative methods, or through quantitative methods. And so far, because I have gone through the analysis of some of the responses just to get a sense, there is a very interesting difference between the different disciplines in terms of the approaches they take when it comes to methodologies. So disciplines which could be generally classified as more scientific or the hard pure sciences are more inclined to adopt quantitative and measurable, maybe not surprisingly, but still it's good to have the data, methods. While disciplines which could be classified under the umbrella of the more soft, pure, or theoretical disciplines, they are inclined not to use quantitative methods, but actually they can be quite critical about that. So that brings the question, how do you negotiate that when you have an interdisciplinary team of different hard pure and soft pure, and I'm using this terminology borrowed by the study of Becher and Trauer on how academics shape different communities and tribes. And the question is, how do you mediate that when you have an interdisciplinary team when it comes to heritage conservation. And this is one of the things that we keep discussing in the networks. Another question is, again, the trying to understand the attitudes among different disciplines towards the idea of involving actively the public. And I would say so far, on the basis of the data so far, there is much greater consensus in terms of that. I think what we need to capture is how is participation, again, understood among different disciplines, like the different levels of participation. So one thing is simply to consult someone or do an interview. The other thing is to actively involve non-experts in the decision-making process. And again, the open boxes are quite important because we get a lot of interesting qualitative data. So once I circulate the questionnaire, I would really value if you filled in these open boxes. And of course, some demographic details, background details, like what is the discipline or disciplines that people represent, the organization they work for, the type of organization, gender, and things like that. The original graph aimed to give you an idea of the different disciplines that are represented in the respondents. So the majority is from architecture, planning, heritage studies, then archaeology and history and anthropology, conservation, heritage management, and a few respondents are from law, geography, economics, heritage science, sociology, museum studies. A couple of respondents said we are multidisciplinary, which I found quite interesting, ethnology and cultural studies. And again, in terms of the countries that the respondents represent, there is a great diversity. So there are people from the United States, Australia, Italy, Germany, Canada, Belgium, Sweden, Slovenia, Singapore, Romania, and so many others. So it's not just Europe. Of course, in order to be able to quantify whether country, for example, has an impact on the attitudes, we need a very, very, very big sample, which we may not be able to collect as part of this study. But it would be interesting to see whether there are some differences which we can further explore in our future research. Now we have also a website, the Heritage Values Net website, which we created from the very, very beginning of the project. The idea is to upload the reports that are coming from the project, but also we invest quite a lot on media, social media. So we have a blog, there is a newsletter. So far we have more than 200 members subscribe to that newsletter, and you are more than welcome to join the newsletter so you can receive all the news and the activities that are happening. Also videos, forums, and try to instigate a dialogue with the wider community on the topic of heritage values. And of course there is a Twitter as well, a Facebook page, and things like that. And we keep putting things on the website, like photos and all this. And the next workshop, as I said, will be in Barcelona. The themes will revolve around social inclusion, heritage values and the wider public, sustainable heritage and participation, tourism and heritage values, and world heritage sites and heritage values. We have presented so far some of the, although that was not part of the network, but we still felt that we need to disseminate even more. So we have presented also academic papers in a couple of international conferences, and we will publish them. And also the idea for this workshop in Barcelona, which follows a little bit of a more traditional now conference style, the intention is to publish them as well as part of an edited volume. But everything will be accessible to the open access. So that's it.